Good morning, and welcome to Little by Little, a short time in God's Word. Yesterday morning was Easter, Resurrection Sunday, and we celebrated the resurrection of Jesus Christ. Everything changes because Jesus is alive. We were in Matthew 28 with a brief stop in 1 Corinthians 15 to kick us off, but we're going to read here in Matthew 28. After the Sabbath, towards the dawn of the first day of the week, Mary Magdalene and the other Mary went to see the tomb. And behold, there was a great earthquake. An angel of the Lord descended from heaven and came and rolled back the stone and sat on it. His appearance was like lightning, his clothing white as snow. And for fear of him, the guards trembled and became like dead men. The angel said to the woman, "Do not be afraid, for I know that you seek Jesus who was crucified. He is not here. He has risen, as he said. Come see the place where he lay. Then go quickly and tell his disciples that he has risen from the dead, and behold, he is going before you to Galilee. There you will see him. See, I have told you." So they departed quickly from the tomb with fear and great joy and ran to tell his disciples. And behold, Jesus met them and said, "Greetings." They came up and took hold of his feet and worshipped him. Then Jesus said to them, "Do not be afraid. Go and tell my brothers to go to Galilee, and there they will see me." While they were going, behold, some of the guard went into the city and told the chief priests all that had taken place. When they had assembled with the elders and taken counsel, they gave a sufficient sum of money to the soldiers and said, "Tell people, his disciples came by night and stole him away while we were asleep. And if this comes to the governor's ears, we will satisfy him and keep you out of trouble." So they took the money and did as they were directed. And this story has been spread among the Jews to this day. Now the 11 disciples went to Galilee, to the mountain to which Jesus had directed them. And when they saw him, they worshipped him. But some doubted. And Jesus came and said to them, "All authority in heaven and on earth has been given to me. Go therefore and make disciples of all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit, teaching them to observe all that I have commanded you. And behold, I am with you always to the end of the age." Lots of great things that we talked about yesterday. He's not here. He has risen as he said. Right? The resurrection validates all that Jesus said. Who he was. Who he knew he was. Who he was trying to portray to others that he was. All that the scriptures of the Old Testament said that he was. It changes how we live, as you see the women worship, as you see the disciples worship. We worship, we serve a risen Lord. But that's not the end. Then also we're given a command to go and to make disciples, to spread the news, to tell others, to train them up in the ways of Jesus. It affects our lives, and it's to affect in increasing ways those around us, because everything changes when Jesus is alive. Until next time, I'm Little by Little.